For a long time, people have assumed that grizzly bears in California only lived in the foothills, near the coast, and in the valleys. But our research has shown that they actually lived pretty much everywhere in the state except in the lowest and hottest deserts. California grizzlies were basically indistinguishable from grizzly bears in Yellowstone National Park and Glacier National Park. California grizzlies were ecosystem engineers, shaping nutrient cycling and soil aeration and seed dispersal. We think of their big claws as being these big ferocious things that they use to prey on other animals, but actually they're more like a hoe to dig in the soil. The truth is that in California, prior to European colonization, grizzly bears here were about 80 to 85% vegetarian. It turns out that the real reason the grizzly bears disappeared from California is that a small number of settlers, armed with guns, traps, and poison, took it upon themselves to eradicate these animals. The received narrative that we've had is that grizzlies had to disappear because they had to give way to civilization. And the fact that there are 40 million people in California today means that they could never come back. These things are simply not true. We could bring grizzlies back if we want to. It's just a choice. It's not impossible. But the key question here is, are we willing to do what it might take to bring them back? Are we willing to make the sacrifices to gain the benefits of coexisting with grizzly bears and other wildlife? The sacrifices are actually pretty small. It involves things like storing your trash, investing a little bit in some infrastructure, and providing ways for them to move from place to place. We have two models based on our recent experience with black bears. One model is what's happened in Lake Tahoe in recent years, where black bears have become an increasing problem, in part because we haven't invested in coexistence in the way that we would need to in order to live with them. But there's another model. Back in the 1990s, there were an enormous number of conflict incidents involving people and black bears in our major national parks. Some agency officials, biologists, conservationists there got some money to invest in secure food storage, education, infrastructure, all of these things that we would need to do. And over the course of about a decade, the number of conflict incidents declined by about somewhere between 95 and 98%. One of the most important things to realize about this story is that anything that we might do for grizzly bears in California would benefit many other species, whether that's restoring ecosystems, whether it's reconnecting patches of fragmented and isolated habitats, whether it's educating people and investing in infrastructure so that all of our food waste doesn't leak into ecosystems and cause so much trouble for so many other creatures. We don't know the extent to which some of those forests are suffering because they're lacking the seed dispersal and nutrients that were provided by some of the species that have either been driven to very low levels or disappeared entirely. That's something that we could get a better understanding of if we actually tried it in the future.